Here at the media classes, you can get real hands-on experience of creating videos, learning about audio, filming, and editing processes.
You guys should join FC Media because it's a super fun class that opens up so many opportunities for you to make different videos and to share those videos with the whole entire school.
I definitely think everyone should take FC Media. I think it's a great class. You really get to push yourself. You get to create what you want to create, have a good time with friends. A lot of time when you're making something, you get full control over it. It's definitely really fun, and I'd recommend it to all.
Knowing how to make videos can open up so many career paths for you. Not only can you build many life skills here, like teamwork, communication, and problem solving, you'll create videos over news packages, make graphics, come up with fun intros, and you could be on FCTV or behind the scenes.
FC Media is so much fun because we get to make videos with our friends every day, and we just get to be in such a fun, creative environment.
My favorite thing about the class is definitely, I'd say, the ability to create. I'm always working on live streams. I get to do all the work. I get to commentate, and it's really been a blessing. I'm really proud of how far I've come, and some of my other commentators, the people I work with on the live streams, and I'd say that's my favorite thing.
Talk to your counselor for signing up for Principles of Broadcasting in the FC Media courses today.
What's up, Flashes? I'm Izzy.
And I'm Kaylee.
Your Franklin Central News for January 31st starts now.
Welcome to another episode of FCTV. I'm Isaac Prickle, your host here. And now we're going to go talk about the case of Gradith Michelle Thompson, a man missing here in this school for eons and years. And there's no rumors that he is here.
Guys, what are you waiting for? FCTV starts now.
Do you like movies? Do you want to hear someone overanalyze and talk about them with their best friend? I got a show for you. This is Corn Popped, where we talk about a lot of movies. Most recently, we talked about Rango. You can come watch it over here on the FC Media YouTube channel.
He bought their affections with showmanship and extravagant gifts of deliciousness. So I too will make this popped corn and win over those mindless drones.
Fade it till he made it. Faked it till he made it.
The girls' bowling team was stopped at regionals recently, but boys' bowling team is still going strong and heading to the state this Saturday. Good luck, boys.
Freshmen, do you have questions about planning your upcoming sophomore schedule? Do you need help in reviewing your options for sophomore year? Plan to attend the scheduling help session for freshmen this Friday, February 2nd, during CCR in room 700. School counselors will be presenting information about scheduling and graduation requirements and will be available to answer any questions you may have in the scheduling process. Make sure to sign up for the counseling workshop / meeting option on the Friday CCR form in Canvas.
Join the ASU this Friday. Bring your friends and ideas to help us plan our next session.
Now, will everyone please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
What's up, guys? I'm Drew Grimes of Sports. Tonight, the Lady Flashes play Southport in the first round of sectionals at 6 p.m. at Pike High School. FC beat Southport 62-26 the last time they played. Lily Graves had 14 points and shot 67% from three. Karis Wilson played the most minutes and then ended up with 10 points. Ashley Baker scored 11 and Emma McVeigh had 10. The winner of tonight's game will play the winner of Ben Davis versus Decatur Central on Friday at 7:30 at Pike High School. Good luck, ladies.
Now it's time for the fun fact of the day. Aside from the French Revolution and helping the Americans during their revolution, King Louis XVI was known for many of his unusual habits, one of which was his unusual alarm clock. Instead of a traditional alarm clock, he had a pet pug named Fortune. Every morning, Fortune would jump into the king's bed, lick his face, wag his tail, signaling the start of the day. Who needs an alarm clock when you have a loyal friend such as Fortune? Make sure you tune into FCTV every day for more fun facts.
Tune in tomorrow for more FCTV news and
thanks for watching.